Hello, Chem 152 students. We are starting with our acid-base titrations today. We're going to start with some quick introductory information, and I wanted to begin today's video with a review of our ice versus change tables. So as we go into acid-base titrations, we will solely be using change tables. But just a quick review that an ice table, remember the E in here stands for equilibrium. So we use these for any systems where we have a weak acid or a weak base in water. Because it sets up equilibrium, we have equilibrium arrows in here, and our units have to be in molarity because we're only using aqueous solutions from now on. We could use pressures for gases, but we need to use molarities for solutions. We solve for X by using an equilibrium constant. And of course, our labels are initial change in equilibrium. For change tables, we use these if we have one or both reactants that are strong. So a strong acid in water or a strong base in water, or strong acid with a strong base. Because that reactant is strong, it forces our reaction to completion. So we have that one direction arrow. And essentially our table is setting up for stoichiometry, so we use units of moles or millimoles. We can find X by determining which one is our limiting reactant, and then our labels for the table are initial, change, or final. Quick review of terminology. With titrations, the titrant is the solution that's in the burette. Usually this is base, but it doesn't have to be. For our purposes in 152, it will be base. The analyte is whatever is unknown that we are trying to solve for. Remember that the equivalence point is our stoichiometric equivalence of the two reactants. This must be calculated. An equivalence point can only be determined through calculation. The end point is where we have the lightest color change possible. So when we add an indicator to a titration, when we get that very, very light color change, that is our end point. And we always want it to be the lightest color change possible so that the equivalence point and end point can be as close to each other as possible so that our end point does estimate our equivalence point. For purposes of our lesson in here, we're going to use a reaction between hydrochloric acid and sodium hydroxide. And of course, we know our reaction there produces sodium chloride and water. Because both reactants are strong, our reaction goes all the way to completion. And the first thing that we want to calculate in a titration is to determine the volume of base that is needed to reach the equivalence point. I'm going to shift the computer a little bit here and actually work through this calculation as a reminder for you. So realize that this calculation is simply a stoichiometry from first semester chemistry. So our known is our HCl because we know its concentration and volume. Our starting point is always to determine how many moles or millimoles we have of that substance. And so here, remember, using our volume in milliliters allows us to calculate, allows us to calculate how many millimoles of HCl we have in solution. Our next step then, of course, is the mole to mole conversion, or millimole to millimole. Again, this is a whole new system for me, so hopefully you can see all of the work. I'm not sure if my image, oh, I can move it. How fun is that? So we'll do our mole to mole conversion next. And then of course, our last step is if we wanna calculate how many milliliters or what volume of base we need, remember that in our molarity definition, molarity is defined as millimoles per milliliter. So if I want to solve for milliliters, I simply need to manipulate that equation to solve for the milliliters of sodium hydroxide. And so that means that since I have millimoles of sodium hydroxide, I'm going to divide that by my concentration. And that will allow me to calculate my volume in, my volume in milliliters.